just now that every day I will be discussing 5 news, okay? And the video will be mostly from 10 to 15 minutes. And newspaper that I will be covering is Indian Express, okay? So I will be taking 5 Indian Express news every day and we'll discuss it from the examination perspective. Ke prelims kis tarike de questions aa sakde hai and mains kis tarike de questions aa sakde hai. So today I have taken 5 important news and pehli khabar ready hai, that is on the front page, okay? Front page upar the first news is with respect to your MTNL and BSNL is going to be merged. And this is very very important news on the left side. And the MTNL and BSNL is going to be merged and the revival plan gets a cabinet vote. This is very important news. I'll be starting with this news initially first. MTNL and BSNL jada hai una da merger ho raha hai. So pehli gal da important hai ki BSNL and MTNL ki karte hai, they are government hai na, public sector units. And what are they doing? They are providing services in the telecom sector. BSNL is active, hai na, everywhere except for Delhi and Bombay. So in Delhi and Bombay, MTNL is active. So Delhi and Bombay, and this is except for these two, all India. So this is first information that we should know. Another, MTNL is the government telecommunication service which is active in Delhi and Bombay, and other than Delhi and Bombay, BSNL is active. Is it absolutely clear? Now the background is very simple. There was a survey in 2017 that was conducted. In this news, they have talked about a survey. In 2017, they conducted a survey. The survey is called the Public Sector Enterprises Survey. Which survey? The Public Sector Enterprises Survey. According to this survey, they concluded that there are certain public sector units which are in loss. Right? So they are in loss. And they concluded that three important public sector units, three important PSUs, which include Air India, BSNL and MTNL, these three important PSUs are basically 52% of the total PSU losses in 2017. Can you imagine? If all the public sector units are having 100 rupees of loss, then almost 52% of the 100 rupees losses were by these three important PSUs. So apart from Air India, BSNL and MTNL are the most important losses. Now why it is so? What is the reason? The reason is very simple. A, there are private companies that have come up and they are offering better services, better quality and at cheap prices. Especially after the Jio coming up. Right? So they are providing 4G services at a very cheaper price. In fact, 4G was free of cost to many subscribers. So most of the people, they shifted to Jio or Airtel or whatever. Private companies are having very quality, also with low cost as well. So people were not purchasing BSNL and MTNL anymore. So number one reason was this, that because of the private companies coming up, there was high competitive cost. What is high competitive cost? So this was very very important. देखो कोई भी enterprise है, any enterprises has two components. One is the cost component, other is the profit component, or the sale component, or the revenue component, है ना? So if any enterprises wants to become profitable, it has to increase its sale and revenue and reduce its cost. That's simple. It has to increase its revenue and reduce its cost. What is happening in BSNL is that sale and revenue is decreasing and cost is increasing. The reason is very simple. Why the revenue is decreasing? Because nobody is purchasing BSNL. Why they are not purchasing BSNL? Because they are preferring private companies. Why they are preferring private companies? Because they are providing high quality services at a cheaper cost. So most of the people are preferring private companies. And other than that, the cost is increasing. Why the cost is increasing? Because there is a high salary component. So BSNL, digital government employees, they have a high salary component as well as pensions. So the pension component is also very high. So because of these two reasons, the cost of BSNL is going up and the revenue is coming down, which is resulting into what? That BSNL is losing out and thus it has become one of the most important public sector unit which is facing immense losses in the past. Now what is government doing? Government has two options. One is to close BSNL, How do you close a public sector unit? You basically privatize it. What do you do? You sell your shares to the private company. The private companies invest in those shares, and finally this BSNL will become a private company. The second important thing is to support BSNL. Now, which particular step the government should take? They have taken not this step, but this step now. This step. Why? Why BSNL is important then? Anyone? Why BSNL is important? Parinder? No, government revenue the aim, it causes losses.
Competition.
Not competition.
Private monopoly.
Private monopoly is already there. Army. The most important factor is army. Right? National security. You can't be outsourcing your national security to private companies. Most of the communications that happens at the army level are BSNL. Second obviously part is, second is disaster management as well. So in disaster management also BSNL helps a lot. So BSNL is very important social enterprise. And there's no profit involved. Suppose tomorrow there is some situation where the government is not, where the private company will always have a role in communication when there is a profit involved. Suppose there is no profit, then the private company will not work. Then the communication should not stop. So ultimately there must be a government company that should ensure the communication is happening, even if the private profit is not there. That is very, very important. For example, army, for example, disaster management, etc., etc. So BSNL should not be down. So for that reason, the government has decided to support BSNL. So government has decided that BSNL no support karoge. How do you support BSNL? Number one. So there are four, five things that the government is doing. Number one, government is making sure that the BSNL starts providing 4G services now. Because BSNL was not providing 4G services and the private companies were doing it, and thus the people were shifting to Jio and every all other networks. So BSNL will now start providing 4G services as well. The second thing the government has started doing is that government will capitalize BSNL, which means that the government will provide additional fund to BSNL. How does the government provide additional fund to BSNL? Government has said that BSNL can issue long-term bonds. The government has said that BSNL will issue long-term bonds, and government will give a sovereign guarantee on these bonds. So government will give a sovereign guarantee, which means now BSNL will come to the market, will issue their bonds, and will ask the public to purchase the bonds of BSNL with an assured interest rate. And if the BSNL falters, if the BSNL is not able to pay back the loan, then who will pay back the loan? The government of India. Because the government has given a sovereign guarantee. So this is the second point which is important in the revival of the BSNL. The third important is that MTNL and BSNL has to be together now. They have to be merged. And they will become one entity. With MTNL becoming subsidiary of BSNL. Now this merger will ensure what? Scale of economy. Scale of economy. The fourth thing that they have said is voluntary retirement scheme. So they are bringing VRS as well. For all the employees of BSNL who are above the age of 50 years. So anyone who is working in BSNL above the age of 50 years, he will be retired off. But obviously, he will not be retired off without any money. He will be given some ex gratia, take this money and get off. That is very important. So it will reduce what? The cost component of BSNL. So VRS will be done. And almost 50% of the employees of BSNL are above the age of 50 years. So this will save a lot of cost for the BSNL. So they are doing a lot of VRS as well. And lastly, we have come to the point is that monetize assets of BSNL. So now BSNL has a lot of land. They have a lot of land. And there is a lot of land which is unused, which BSNL is not using. That is an asset of BSNL, but it is not yet monetized. Monetize का मतलब है, if you sell that land, whatever value you get from that land is monetization of that land. Are you clear on this? उन्हों कहने आपा monetization of land. Suppose मेरी जमीन है, वो पहली है, वो दी कोई value नहीं है. अगर मैं बेचूंगा तो मुझे कुछ पैसे मिलेंगे. That selling of the land and getting the money in the bank is what monetization. So BSNL has lot of property right now, but most of the properties are unused. Sell that property, get that money in your bank, and monetize that asset. So this is the fifth important revival plan that cabinet has given to it. So this is why very five important points that OG role, capitalize BSNL, MTNL, voluntary retirement schemes, and monetize the assets of BSNL will ensure somehow that the BSNL gets a revival. है ना again. तो ये जितने पांच important factors हैं, है ना कितना के लिए lead कर दे BSNL को support करने के लिए. So this is something which is important. Now what kind of question you can come? Mains दे विच generally इतना कोई question नहीं आएगा कि why BSNL and MTNL were merged, है ना और etc. In mains the question that can come is, please make sure it can come on public sector units performance. So a very general question can come ke in the globalization era, in the era of privatization or in the era of competition, hai na, how do you analyze the performance of various public sector units which are not performing to the par, hai na, etc. For example, there are many PSUs that are getting losses, hai na. For example, Air India bhi baat ho rahi hai almost, hai na, baat ho rahi hai kagar de, people are talking about privatizing here. Railways also not performing well, they are also in losses, and BSNL, MTNL are also in losses. So you can get a question, general question, ki public sector units globalization the time they in a key role reh chuke hai, hai na, such kind of question. And here you can give the example of BSNL as a fodder point. कि BSNL द की सिचुएशन थी एंड बेसिकली द ओनली थिंग इज कि व्हाई द BSNL इज परफॉर्मिंग सो बैडली इज दैट देयर इज अ ह्यूज कंपटीशन फ्रॉम द प्राइवेट सेक्टर द प्राइवेट सेक्टर इज कॉम्पिटिटिव द प्राइवेट सेक्टर इज एंड अ कॉस्ट एफिशिएंट एंड ऑल दोस फैक्टर्स सो दिस इज अ न्यूज़ व्हिच आई फाउंड इट इंपॉर्टेंट ठीक है सो सेकंड न्यूज़ आप देख लें दिस इज द सेकंड न्यूज़ इज इन योर एक्सप्लेन सेक्शन A very very important news. In fact, there have been 3-4 days. This news is in, you know, always in the paper. I hope you're following this news. You know, the news is with respect to Crime Record Bureau. NCRB has published a very long-awaited data on crime status in India. So what happens is there's a body called NCRB. Yes. What is the name? Yes. I will explain it. बॉडी है उसका नाम है नेशनल नेशनल क्राइम रिकॉर्ड ब्यूरो इट्स अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बॉडी कॉल्ड नेशनल क्राइम रिकॉर्ड ब्यूरो एंड दिस बॉडी इज ऑफ इज अंडर व्हिच मिनिस्ट्री होम अफेयर्स यस सो दिस बॉडी इज अंडर मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ होम अफेयर्स हु इज द होम मिनिस्टर ऑफ इंडिया ठीक है सो ही इज बेसिकली द है ना द माई बाप ऑफ दिस बॉडी है ना नेशनल क्राइम रिकॉर्ड ब्यूरो नाउ मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ होम अफेयर्स एंड नेशनल क्राइम रिकॉर्ड ब्यूरो दे पब्लिश अ रिपोर्ट एवरी ईयर दे पब्लिश अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रिपोर्ट एवरी ईयर विच टॉक्स अबाउट द क्राइम रिकॉर्ड इन इंडिया कि हाउ द क्राइम ट्रेंड इज गोइंग ऑन है ना So what they do is they basically and all the police stations in India, they are all registering FIRs and finally they are registering charge sheets and finally they are bringing all the data that who has been found guilty and who has not been found guilty and etc. And they are also bracketing those crimes like for example certain crimes that are done against women, certain crimes that are done against property. So they're bracketing those crimes as well. And finally they are getting this report. And every year this report is coming, and in 2017 this report came in 2016, and then in 2017 the report should have come, and but in 2017 the report did not came. In 2018 the report should have come, it did not came in 2018. Now in 2019, at the end of 2019, finally the report is out, which is first of all not a good thing to do, and because you have to publish this report every year. But if this has been not been getting published for the past 2 years, now finally you're getting a report in 2019. And this report is the macro that has started a debate in India. So key debate start kiti hai, anyone? Anyone? Key debate start kiti hai? So yes, there are many positives and there are many negatives of the report. So let us discuss first of all positives. And okay, what are the key points or key positives that are there in the report, okay? Which were not there in the previous reports. So what are the positives? So sabse pehla positive hai ki there have been new categories of crime. So the sabse pehla positive ye hai ki we have brought in new categories of crime now, hai na? So what are the new categories of crime that you have brought? We have brought, hai na, your categories of crime in yes, crime against women and children. So sabse pehla we have brought many important categories, crime against women and children. The second thing that we have brought, that the second very important thing that you brought is crime against Dalits. The third thing which we have brought is corruption. And lastly, which is very interesting of this report, is that the report has been talking about the delay. Okay? The delays that happen in the entire process. So these are very four important things. So crime against women and children, crime against Dalits, corruption, and finally the fourth thing is, you know, the delays that are happening in the entire process of criminal justice system. So ek bari aap dekh rahe hain ki crime against women and children jinhone ki introduce kiya hai. So they have introduced very interesting thing, cyber crimes they have introduced. So they have brought cyber crimes. So earlier on they never used to have this another category of cyber crimes in the NCRB report. Now they have brought a report of cyber crimes apart from the general crimes that happen. This cyber crimes they have taken from IT Act. All the crimes that are registered under the Information Technology Act. There is a special law. I told you there are two kind of laws. General law and special law. General law is IPC, special law is Information Technology Act. So they have brought cyber crimes. And very, very, very important. They have brought cyber crimes. Okay? So crime against women and children. Then they have reported that rapes have gone up, you know, in the past. And the data which they have brought is how much? Almost 33,000 rapes they have reported. You know, generally, roughly 33,000 odd rapes they have reported. So in India, every year you are getting how many rapes? 33,000. If you divide it with 365, you will get how much per day? Aa jayega na data, kitna ho jayega? Almost 1900, almost 900. I'm just trying to analyze. Almost 900 days. 900 divided by 24, almost it will be roughly around 1 hour. Kitne ho jayenge? 4 rapes, and not 24 into almost 24 4 are 40 rapes, okay, and almost 40 rapes in an hour. So probably you can well imagine, see, this is the situation of India when it comes to women security. So there are almost like 40 rapes happening every hour. Now in this 40 rapes, they have also included murder after rape. This is very interesting. They have included murder after rape as well. So there are roughly around 227 odd cases where the rapists have murdered the women as well after the rape. Now that's something which they have brought in due. ठीक है? To make sure कि ये चीज हो रही है. है ना? दस से जा रहा है कि ये चीज हो रही है कि even after raping a woman, है ना, there is a murder happening. So almost like there are 227 nirpyas in India happening every year. So one case, Nirbhaya case, was there, and that broke the soul of India. There have been 227 Nirbhayas happening in India every year. That's a very harsh reality. They have also got a category of child rapes as well. So child rapes have been included separately. Okay? Child rapes are a separate part included, and that have been included under POXO Act. So jada POXO Act was under declare kiya hai. And even POPSO Act will include that, the child will include that. How many children are getting raped in India? Any data? 28,000. So that's also a very big number. So 28,000 children are getting raped in India, and that data they have got. And that is very, very strong data that they have got. Apart from this, they have also talked about sexual harassment for women at public places. Transportation, kitna sexual harassment ho raha hai, and definitely your kithe ho raha hai, aur kithe ho raha hai, workplace se. But they are not very high number, and almost 400, 500 number hai gaya, sexual harassment and workplace. So they are bringing new crimes against women and children, and so that's very important. Dalit. Now when you come to Dalit, they have included very interesting categories for Dalit. For example, they have included insults, land grabs. So they have included insults. Anyone insulting a Dalit is a crime. Anyone grabbing the land of Dalit is a crime. And anyone socially ostracizing Dalit, which means social exclusion of Dalit, is a crime. So they have also included these three interesting categories when it comes to crimes against Dalits in India. That's very interesting. And finally, they have brought corruption. Corruption of public servants. Corruption of public servants. And in this they have included, very interesting, they have said that there can be two kinds of corruption. One corruption is done by high officers. Another kind of corruption is done by low officers. Low government employees. Low ni kaya saagya aapka kama ke? Government employees jide ke? Group C or group D de hai. High officers are interesting. To know how much corruption these high officers have done, they have brought the category of disproportionate assets. Disproportionate assets. What do you mean by this? If their total property, and if their total property is not in sync, if their total property is not in sync with their income levels, then they have disproportionate assets. Proportionate asset means that when their total property is in sync with their incomes. Now, generally high officers have disproportionate assets. And if they are getting incomes of 70,000, 80,000 a month, but they are having huge bungalows and etc. So they have disproportionate assets. And that's something which they have brought out. And for the government employees, they have brought trap cases. Very interesting. New cases are coming. Trap case. What is a trap case? When there is somebody who is trapped in taking a bribery. Suppose है ना कोई पुलिस वाले ने कोई bribery दे दिया, ऐसे क्या है वो फाड़ लिया किसी ने, फोटो बना ली, वीडियो बना ली, that's called a trap case, है ना. तो इन trap cases they brought how many है ना government employees are held in trap cases. So they brought these kind of new categories. And finally they brought delay. Now what is delay? They brought a very interesting concept called charge sheet. Charge sheet generally जेने IPC दे अंदर charge sheet होती है. What is the charge sheet? पहला FIR होता है, first information report, है ना? FIR होता है, first information report. Whenever there is a crime that is reported, so the first information report is there. After the FIR is registered, if the crime falls under the Indian Penal Code, है ना? There is a criminal procedure code in India which says that after the filing of FIR, after the registration of FIR, any crime which is conducted under the Indian Penal Code has to be, the charge sheet has to be prepared within 90 days. This is the time that is there. Na? What is charge sheet? Charge sheet is that, you know, us bande nu kede kede crime kitte us bande ne, hai na, kede kede law de andar nu assi implicate kariye. So within 90 days you have to file the charge sheet and you have to present that charge sheet in front of the judge, hai na. Now in India, in last year, 40% of the total cases, how many? 40% of the total cases. You don't have to remember this data. No need to remember this data. But yes, you need to know ki what is the gravity of delays that are happening. Now 40% of the total cases have exceeded this 90 days of timeline. So that's huge. Almost like, you know, second case out of fifth case is delayed in India. And then they have said 60% of these cases, 40% is total cases, 60% of these cases are those cases which involve communal riotings, which involve mob lynchings, you know? So communal rioting and mob lynching the cases in which the delay is 60%, which means if 100 cases of mob lynching is there, 60% cases are delayed charge sheets. So that's a very strong statement. Then they have also brought, you know, ke fast track quota concept liya hai India. Liya hai na? What is fast track code? Fast track code is a code which will try to solve a particular case in a fast track manner, which means it is assumed that a court will regularly be held and there will be extra money that will be shelled out to the judges. The advocates will not make excuses. They will not take time. Every day they will be hearing. Even the hearing can continue till evening. So there will be like mission mode project hoega ki apne aap pura case jo hai fast track complete karna hai. In fast track courts, it is expected that the judgment should be delivered within a period of 1 year. Is it or not? That is why they are fast track. Now what is happening in fast track courts? They mention a data, very interesting data. They mentioned 40% of the cases in fast track courts. 40% of the cases in fast track courts are pending for more than 3 years. So even the fast track courts are not fast enough. So 40% of the cases which are in fast track are pending for more than 3 years. That's again a very interesting data they have come up. इतना नहीं है कि डेटा बुरा आया है ना, बहुत सही सी डेटा आया है. Got very interesting data. And they've also brought a data on cyber crime, that cyber crime in India is increasing. And 77% jump by cyber crime in India. Cyber crime is 77% jump. So all these are positives of this new report, National Crime Record Bureau. I'm repeating again. National Crime Record Bureau is under the Ministry of Home Affairs and they publish a crime data every day, every year. For the past 3 years, the data was not getting published. 2019, finally, the sense prevailed and they published this data. In this data, there are certain positive takeaways and there are negative takeaways. The positive takeaway includes that they have included new categories of crime. So broadly, if you see, there are four important changes that they have done. A, they have brought crime against women and children, which are already existing, but yes, definitely they have brought new crimes like cyber crime. They have talked about rape and also they have talked about how many women were murdered after the rape. They talked about child rape and now they are also talking about how many children were murdered after the child rape. Then against Dalit, they brought new concepts like insults against Dalit, grab land, social exclusion, etc. And then finally, they brought corruption and the delays that are happening. So that's these are the positives of the crime record. What are the negatives? Let us discuss the negatives. Negatives. So, sabse pehla negative, jo bahut zyada hurtful hai, in fact, is that farmer suicides nahi publish ho raha. That's very, very hurtful. Farmer suicides is not getting published. In fact, 2015 to pehla publish hunda siga ki how many farmers have committed suicide in India. In 2015 onwards, they have stopped publishing this data that how many farmers have committed suicide in India. Now, when you don't know how many farmers have committed suicide in India, how will you bring solution to the agriculture crisis that is happening in India right now? तो फार्मर सोसाइटीज जो थे बहुत ज़्यादा हर्टफुल है कि इन्होंने डेटा पब्लिश नहीं किया. इन 2019 हो गया, सो वी हैव नॉट गॉट एनी डेटा ऑन फार्मर सोसाइटीज. सेकंड इशू इज दैट दे हैव एक्सक्लूडेड डेटा ऑफ मॉब लिंचिंग. दैट्स आल्सो वेरी हार्श. टुडे देयर वाज अनदर पीस ऑफ आर्टिकल इन इंडियन एक्सप्रेस व्हिच टॉक्स अबाउट मॉब लिंचिंग. दे हैव सेड दैट द गवर्नमेंट इज नॉट गिविंग डेटा हाउ मेनी हैव बीन मॉब लिंच्ड. But yes, definitely from independent sources we are coming to know that almost like there are 25 to 26 deaths that have happened in the past 8 years due to mob lynching. And out of those 24-25 deaths, almost 22 to 23 deaths are of Muslims. So there's a pattern here involved. And apart from Muslims, there are only few other religion people who are dying because of the mob lynching. And they have purposefully omitted the mob lynching data. Then they have also omitted the data of khap killings. That is also very important. Probably it's political. So khap killings also have been omitted. What is khap? Khap is that panchayat that are active in Haryana, which issues diktars to kill women who try to marry outside the caste. So you know, honor killing and there. So khap killings, another data they have not published is that killings by influential people. Now what is this? Killings by influential people. So they have not talked about anything. Okay, how many influential people have killed? How many? So probably they are talking about politicians. Then they have also omitted a data of killing by religious people. Or crime done by religious people. I will not name religious people. You have many Babas in